Welcome back to Captain Phelps's recording studios. Funny. I'm an old man. I've been playing this game for as long as it's been out. Today I think I'm just going to explain a lot of videos you get on No Man's Sky you get from normal. And not everybody plays normal. They want a little bit of challenge. Some of us play survival and permadeath. Well, I play all three types, including the creative, just to try out new ideas. Mainly, I was trying to learn how to glitch base parts on creative. It's not as easy as it looks. Some of them are not meant to go together. But I thought today I would show you a stasis base designed to make stasis devices and make a lot of cash. And I'm going to show you the differences between normal and survival. I would be showing you the difference between survival and permadeath, and I will in the upcoming months, but my permadeath ain't up that high. I accidentally died. Okay, so here's the stasis base on normal. As you can see, several bases, buildings, normal. I had to three of these down. I don't like stacking them, but I was only able to find a C-class, which gives you 49%. That's this one. All three of them. I do have one right on top. Here's another 49%. Looks like this is all I'm going to get on normal. Yeah, this is 48%. So the biggest one I got on the C. 48. I was not able to find an S. I searched for days. I couldn't find a B. This planet just could not find one. One of the glitches I did use on this base, mainly because I didn't want to have to keep putting base computers down all over the place. What I did, and you see here, pieces of wood wall. I would walk out or fly out to the perimeter of the base, which is usually around 300 meters, 300 units, 300 kilometers, depending on what unit base you're using on No Man's Sky. And I extended it past. So all what you see here, this one, that, well, it's not a base anymore, but it's a mining area on this one base here. I also glitched it the other direction to get it to go over here. This is beyond my base perimeter as well. You can see you're limited to 5,000 pieces on each base. However, this looks like more than 5,000 pieces. I do have quite a few solar panels. I started here. Let me show you. I'm going to photo mode. I have 31 domes. I have everything that I need. Every plant that you can plant, except for nip-nip buds, is growing. And these agricultural domes gives me quite a bit of plant life. Come back down. You're not allowed to have. Okay, I might need to do decorative stuff here. I haven't finished my decorating yet, but I'm getting there. You're only allowed 2 refinery bases. Some people have shown you that you have 3 or 4. The game doesn't allow for it, and so I'm using the normal parameters for this. However, I have added these different areas. Here is my carbon house. You need carbon. Lots of it. Lots and lots of carbon. You have to have lots of carbon. So this is dedicated to all nothing but carbon. And I even have, and we use so much of it, I even have more. Oh, this base. These animals are always messing with me. As you can see, I put down more solar, more batteries. I'm only using solar and batteries. I'm not using the furnace at all. And that's enough to keep this particular building up 24 hours a day. Really kind of cool. Always put a save point in case I want to quit here. Teleporter going back and forth. And that's where all my storage bins in. As you can see, I'm at 4,032,947,299 units. 39,000 nanites, 1,405 quicksilver, because I spend it as fast as I get it. I don't know why, but I like the quicksilver items. As you can see, I like it if I buy them all. Hey, dude. Let's see. Keep up the storage. As you can see, I've got a lot of things made already. I got 36 stasis pods here. I don't know, 56 stasis pods. And I spend a lot of units as well upgrading my ships that I find. And I get bored. Yeah, I get bored. I sell them and buy them all the time. It's kind of fun. And I have, let's see, 40, 60, 71 explosive liquid explosives. Yes, I can also create off of this base. I'm not just limited to a stasis device. I can create. Oops, sorry. A fusion igniter. It makes us just as much, 15,600 units per piece. You still need the quantum processor. You need make a lot of the quantum processors. I don't keep my quantum processors in my storage because I'm always building. Down to my vehicles. So there's my Explorer driving in right now. Got a little lag for some reason this morning. It's probably because of everybody playing. The weekend event's coming up. And as you can see, got a line of quantum processors here. The denial's worth as much, 17 million per, or actually 22 million per stack, which is a stack of 5. Polypolymer circuit board. I make everything here, and I just kind of use my Colossus. It's got a nice big inventory, and I keep them there. Living glass, everything I need. And I have all of the vehicles. I do not have to fly anywhere in the system. All I have to do is teleport. I've built a base in every mining area. You're gonna need a system, preferably 5 or more planets, that you can gain Sufrine, Radon, Nitrogen Gas. You need those three elements. You use them every single time you make a stasis field. Radon, you need a lot of it because it's used on both sides of the crafting. It crafts the circuit board, or the quantum processor. You need the radon for the other side for the portable. And let's see, yeah, you need stasis device requires a cryogenic chamber, adirocyte, quantum processor. Everybody keeps forgetting about this adirocyte, I'll explain it. But a cryogenic chamber is quite easy to make, so is a quantum processor. They're all made if you have the materials, so what you have to do. Tell you what, I'll just go up into space and explain the planet system. I won't do the same thing in survival, but I will explain it now. Where is my ship? Oh, there it is. So you preferably need a star bowl. You can see all the bases I have created. Okay, so I have this base here, which is Scorched Planet. You get your phosphorus, which you need, selenium, which you need. You have to have all two of those things, plus you need the Sufrine. We're going to get that as a Scorched Planet. I didn't do anything there mainly because it's got a high sentinel. Paradise Planet. Not much of a paradise planet if you're fighting sentinels all the time. And the furthest one out is a fissure planet. I get copper, gold, and cobalt. I need all three of those for the stasis devices. And here I have a frostbound where I get the dioxide, silver, and let's see what else did I get there. Oh, frost crystal. Huh. And I didn't build anything on this one because I've never had to go there. But it is, you see I got five or six ancient bones. Selenium activated, phosphorus, and sodium. So you need all those things for a stasis device. I am not going to fly to everyone because it'll just take too long, so I'll just go back down here. Let's see if I can collect what I need for today's harvesting. See, it's kind of cool the way the base is set up. Alright, so let's go down here before I leave. I'm really into animals. I like animals. So I always feed my characters. I do not know why I am showing my lines. This must be a glitch today. I got a little picnic area here. And my harvesting units. I have them all over my... I have one on the other side and I have one here. These guys are always getting fed. I always feed them. I harvest. I get wild milk, regular milk, eggs. And all kinds of different things. And here's another one. I had to keep adding solar panels and batteries until I got a 24 hours of power. It never goes out now. You have to play with it. When I put these the ag buildings in, I would have to disconnect it from the main area every once in a while so I can keep using stuff to buy and sell and whatnot. But I finally was able to add enough batteries and solar deals. So you got, I got them here, I got them on top of the building, I got them in between, I got them everywhere. Because I only have 48% of the power from those three. This base over here, actually it's not a base, but just fly on over here. It's within flying distance. You see I glitched it out. And you can see I went beyond this area. There's no base computer here. Change colors. It's got its own power as well, and enough batteries to keep the building powered up. Here I get oxygen, which I have to have all the time. I get 12,250 at any given time. Another animal trying to kill me. I don't like killing them, but he's trying to kill me. Ow, 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 that hurt. Sorry. Feline liver for dinner. And you can see another refinery and lots more carbon again. I'll be coming back today to harvest this. Interesting thing about the carbon. It regenerates. It grows very fast. I can empty out my carbon house. And by the time I go to another planet and come back, it's already grown back. Well, that animal's trying to kill me too, but let's just see if I can get away from it. I'm tired. I filled up my inventory with liver and animal meat. And chasing me. Something is very wrong here. I don't know why. My doohickey's not working. I do have one of those things. See? It keeps the wires from showing. So there must be something going on with the servers today. Sorry. Here we go. Nitrogen base. Takes a while, it's been tough for a little while. I don't know why it takes so long, but sometimes it takes a long time, sometimes it don't. You can see here, I'm in the same system. More carbon. Lots and lots of carbon, see? And if I get stuck in a storm or something, for a deal, I have another refinery. I just kind of differently than I've seen before. Five here at 18,225. You need a lot. 18,250. It takes a while. This is only a C class. So it does take 242 hours to get 250 units of nitrogen. Was unable to find a B or an A. Boy, if I do, I will plug another one down and put it in there. Cobalt, which you need a lot. flat and don't have to leave very far. You need cobalt for ionized cobalt. You need to have that. The main reason you need it is to make the iridescite. It takes ionized cobalt to make two of the items, along with condensed carbon. So you need a lot of condensed carbon. You need a lot of cobalt. You can see it doesn't take much to power these. I only have, I don't know, 10 solar panels and 8 batteries, and it runs at almost 24 hours. Takes a lot. I get gold off this planet. You can see I can get copper, silver, sulfurine, dioxide, paraffinium, which you need a lot of for planting, phosphorus for the iridescite, sodium, paraffinium, which I do have another one, which is S-class. You need radon. I have 2 radon bases. It takes so much. Of course, I have uranium. You run out of uranium. Another sulfurine that I can pull from. And the oxygen, which is S-class. That second nitrogen. The reason why I have maybe more than one nitrogen and one more radon is it's such a low class mining area. It takes a long time to do it, but I can pick up a lot more by having more than one. You can see I have a circuit board base, but I haven't been back there in a while. If I run out of stuff, I can go there and get some for circuit boards. Sulfurine. Another base, it's not mine. DJ Monkey. I don't know if he's played in a while. I haven't seen him on in a long while. But he built this place. I thought you might want to see it. It's kind of interesting. But his harvester is over here. His power's here. I think he went a little crazy on the power structure, but he put a lot of them here. He hasn't been here in a while because you see everything's starting to grow around him. Oh, that's right. This is where the place where an old S-class used to be. And the power's over there. God, you can't even get in here. Pretty bad. Oh, there's my ship. He doesn't have a landing base here, which I find interesting. Wow. Doesn't have a lot here at all. I never did finish it, I don't think. I got bored with the game. Got more than one of these here, you can see. Extracting. Wow, it's something. These are coming underneath. And his, and it goes to, he goes right back here. Where the storage units are. Maybe. I don't know why he's not coming back. He hasn't been back here in a while. But in any case, I have everything I need, and everything I listed, you have to have. You have to have copper, you have to have nitrogen, you have to have cobalt, sulfurine, dioxide, paraffinium, silver, sodium, phosphorus, paraffinium, and sulfurine. Of course, I have extra radon, and oxygen is always useful. I also even have a magnetized ferrite. Back to the stasis farm. Difference between normal and survival, you'll notice survival and normal 8250 cobalt, 9999 sulfurine, 9999 carbon if I wanted to, 9999 ionized cobalt each of your inventory slots, as well as cargo. You can see dioxide, plenty of it. Nitrogen, phosphorus. I can keep it all on me at any time. I don't have to really fight for it. I mean, I have plenty of inventory. Normal is actually pretty easy to play because of this. Your storage space holds so much. You need the dioxide and iodized cobalt for granitine. You have to have the sulfurine condensed, takes a lot. That's not what I wanted to make. Magna gold, phosphorus, and ionized cobalt. These are all the items people used to throw away. Irinium is from paraffinium and chlorine. Actually, paraffinium ionized cobalt. That's what I use. You can use chlorine, but I use ionized cobalt because it allows me. I'm on an older one. And here I can just make deer sack. Takes one of each of those. Sulfurine and condensed carbon. This does take time. I'm not going to do it all. Oh, I don't know if I have room. Nope. Don't have room anyways. That's why I use all these storage spaces. So you can imagine. I'm out the room. And you gotta just store it until I need it. I might use all of this when I get enough of each of them, but I make anywhere from thermic condensate. I need about 60, so each time I make that, I have to have at least 60 of them. Out of condensed carbon. So I have to go make some more. Okay, so that is a normal stasis base. I'll just take you through here. This is not going to be the same as survival because I haven't finished it. I'm still in process. This took me about a week to build. Mainly, it took me, and the reason why it took me a week to build is because it took so long to find some of the mining areas. It took me the longest to find cobalt. And you have to have it. You see, I have everything I need. I need gamma for the liquid corrosive. Mordite. This actually makes both stasis devices and the infusion device. Oh, I'm lost. Oh, here we go. Go through here. A lot of twists and turns. I would be collecting this, but I'm going to go back to survival here real quick. I don't want to just leave it empty. Come back with full. No way, I don't know what I'm doing. Selenium at the end and come out on the other side. Cool? Cool. Always have this. I'm not finished with this base either. I still have a lot of decorating to do on all my bases. Let's go to quick mode, take a quick intermission. Gonna make a quick intermission and be right back. Actually, before I take my intermission, I gotta show you that I'm actually in survival because it's gonna take a little bit to load up. I'm gonna load a survival mode. You'll notice I have two of them and a permadeath. Now I'll take a intermission. Be right back. Scene survival, not as grandiose as you can see. That's the same, not as grandiose. So far, I've only got like, I don't know, 12, 4, I have 22 of these so far. I mainly filled up with gamma weed, frost crystal, some star bulb, and I'm not done planting. Oh, Mordite. I'm still not done planting. I'm not finished. I still have a few more things to plant. But it's taken me already 2 weeks to build this. Because it is really difficult to find the mining areas. They don't pop up as easy. my storage, you can see I can't carry anything. Phosphorus 250, 250, 42, 250. I can't carry as much. I had to have my refiner, so I put two of each. Medium and that, because I use it all the time. I got carbon in here. I got my storage spaces. I do have enough power for everything. Mainly because I've got two rows of batteries, two rows of solar panels in back here. Again, I think this is a C class. Nope, it's a B class with 71%. I still needed power. It takes a lot of power in survival. So, here we go. More batteries. More solar. That is not all. More solar and more batteries. And my carbon. Vehicles are down here. We have a teleporter down here. Small. This solar panel has to run that teleporter. It takes a lot of power and survival. My design for this base is mainly to stay off the ground because I have a lot of little critters that try to eat me while I'm collecting carbon all the time. They are always biting me, so I had to raise it up a little bit. Even I raised it up as high as I did. Look how high I am. I'm full wall higher off the ground. I should have went higher. And I still get these animals eating, biting me. I could be sitting up here on my couch. Enjoying my view, which is really nice. And I'll get bit. Go back up top. As you can see, I am not done. I got gamma weed. This is taking me 2 weeks just to build this, to try and get this done. Find the materials. I got the materials. I only have, well, yeah, 1,600,945,919,535 8,000 nanites. You can see, and I've been playing this game for 7 years. I know what I'm doing. That was a glitch. Anyhow, selenium. Everything's ready to harvest in here. So I'll have to harvest it this afternoon. I gotta put some more selenium in here. I'm gonna need some cactus in here and see if I have enough. But I am not. I don't want to say I did it a lazy way, because I'm still looking for a phosphorus mining place. So I'm still buying phosphorus. I haven't found phosphorus mining yet, so I am still looking for that. It's a lot harder to find it. I don't know why I'm having such trouble. But it's fun. It's fun to do, though. But as you can see, I'm basically doing the same thing. However, one thing different. I'll start with this. One thing different. Oh man, gaming circuit board base number 2. I do have a circuit board base I've connected to this one. Make it a little bit easier. Wasn't going to do that, but it is taking twice as much resources to craft, and it takes longer to. I can't carry everything when I go. So I always make 2 or 3 runs to get the supplies I need. So I went over here. I already built this one on a different planet. It's still a star bowl. You'll find it's kind of interesting. I'm trying to save materials at this point until I get the stasis board build base going really heavy. And this is what I did, as I put 10 of these out here. All I planted was star bulb, and you can see that star bulb is, I made a nice design out of it. I put it around each, and as you can see, they are able to harvest them. It may take a little longer. It takes me about, I don't know, 5-10 minutes just to collect all this. But the problem is I have to craft halfway through here because I've run out of room. You can see I'm running out of room real fast. That is one of the big challenges of survival, is you don't have as much inventory space, and you're not able to carry as much. Hence the name survival. Out of room. So here, we'll just go over here, and this is what I do. Interesting little trick that I found for crafting purposes only. Colossus. Since I already opened it on the other side, it was on the other side, I have to open it here. You can see, look at all these quantum processors. And I can still craft in here. To make more circuit boards. That's what the star bulb's for. Star bulb and cactus flesh. I'm finally running out of cactus flesh. But see, no more star bulb. Added it up, I can make a line or two star bulbs with this amount here. And it's a pretty design. I always put my nutrient processor down, because here my landing pads are in the back, but I have several of these harvesters. All around the base. Which takes polyfiber, by the way. So if you have any missions to do, oh, I had to put an extra one out here. I needed extra selenium, so I just threw one out here on the side. And here's another harvester. And you can see I got the trick here that I was going to explain, I forgot. Before I got sidetracked, I get sidetracked so easily. It's the fact that this vehicle here is full. Crafted here. I'm on a different planet. Same system, but a different planet. I can craft in here. And when I go back, all I have to do is enter that, and I have access to that as well. So I can craft everything I need here to save myself time. Go back to the stasis board, stasis device base, go down to this vehicle here, and craft the other half. And I don't have to transport anything. Makes it really nice. But as you see, very pretty, very functional. Got everything I need there. And all I have to do is teleport. It's got the radon base. Wow, sorry. It's gonna be a long video, I think. back there. You can see how yellow it is out here? Because we're on radioactive planet. Let's re-get this. You can see I harvested the other day. And I don't have enough room. So this is what happens. I end up filling up. Ship. Exosuit. Cargo. Ship. All full. And I put the rest in the freighter. Interesting enough to know, though, I still have a refiner, and I always end up putting, even though it's a little smaller, inventory full, I'm full. So, that's the reason why I have this set up. Purposes of base, video, I didn't, show you that, but I'm trying to save time and money on my video. But I notice I don't need a whole lot of batteries here. But we're gonna run out of fuel here in a minute, so I better get off this base. Oh no, here they come. Opening up again. Sun's coming up. I always start with this. I always find this interesting. I didn't notice it real. I do put a bio first in here just in case I run out of power so I can turn on the teleporter so I can get out of here. But you don't have to connect these or anything. You put these on top of this and you immediately get power. Then you can connect the base to that thing there, these, and you get. You notice a big fan of color, purple, for radon. Well, let's get out of here before we get stuck. You can see I have the copper, which is an S-class. Nitrogen base. Sulfurine mining. Dioxide mining. Gold mining. Paraffinium, 2 paraffinium because I needed so much. That's a buddy of mine's basis. Like show up in purple, that's friend's base. So I have access to his as well. And mine his. And the oxygen base. I needed all those. Sorry, I'm losing my voice this morning, it looks like. Back here. So here I had to be a little creative. I had to put a circuit board base down to save area and materials. And then I put the stasis board base that I labeled as such for the other half of the crafting supplies. Because I never have enough power. Just never have enough power. Or the resources. It takes me a long time. I've been at this base here, like I said, 2 weeks? At least 2 weeks. I'm starting my third week working on this. And I'm still not finished. I still haven't found all. I still haven't found the cobalt. I still haven't found sodium. There's a like 3 or 4 items I am still looking for. And once I get in, I'll be up and running full time, and I'm still able to make things and make money. But I am still having to buy phosphorus and whatnot. As you can see, I'm only at 1,694,919,535 units. Oh. One thing I wanted to tell you, which I find really interesting, kind of a fluke, my freighter, which is right there, that's a new freighter. I had an A-class on survival, but after last week's weekend event, which was quite easy, it was the Pugnium one, where you had to go kill a bunch of sentinels. Well, I didn't have to kill anything because I had plenty of Pugnium. sentinels are always shooting at me at one time or another, and I always kill them as they attack me. And so I already had enough to make to do the weekend event. So all I had to do is fly there, go and do it. And you can see the space is fairly close, but I could not glitch it. Like I said, this is my nitrogen base. Kind of pretty. We were already there. I always kind of like showing you what it looks like from the ground, from the sky a little bit. You can see it here. Not bad. Carbon house. Kind of pretty. Kind of limited where you put it, because I found go up here. After the weekend event, like I was saying, I ran into this by went back. I was hooked up to this unknown British guy, or friend, no French guy. This French guy. Just helped him out. He got the weekend event done real quick. And he got into a battle, and here I was. Finish decorating. When I finish decorating, I'll come show you. I'm going to make it a little bit different as my other ones. And that should do it today. Thank you much.